I need to be quick tonight, so this is the final episode about inherited widget and all the funny things that come with it. So as I promised, today we will be doing something I encourage you not to do. So we will be implementing mutable inherited widget. Let me start by creating this widget first. So I will create a class and I will call it ugly provider, because we already have this right provider there. So this will be an ugly provider, and we will remove that class afterwards once it's explained. So this is going to be stateful widget, as I said in the previous episode, where I was rambling about inherited widget. I showed you this image, how a mutable inherited widget is structured. So we have this stateful widget, which consists of two classes, the widget class and the state class. And then we have inside the state class, we have this inherited private widget. So let's go ahead and implement that. So this is ugly provider. This is material like that. So here in this state, we will define the state for this, the state we want to mutate. So this is going to be, let's say, integer. So we also need init state. And let's say it's 1. Because why not? So now we need to implement another class, and this class will be private. So just by convenience, I'm naming it the same as the first class, but I'm using the underscore at the beginning. The underscore has two functions. The first one is that it's different than this class. It's a different name. And the second one is a private class, because we don't need to make it public. It can only exist in the context of this file. And this class, this is the actual inherited widget. So this is the class that extends the inherited widget. So we have to implement this update should notify. And in this case, let's mark it as true. So now in the state class, where there is the build method, we need to build this inherited widget, this private inherited widget, whenever there is a change within the state. So we will just do a ugly provider like that. The provider needs the data it provides, so this is going to be final. And just again, for the convenience, I will mark this data as a reference to the entire state class here. So I will just say that the data this provider provides is of the type of this state. And this will be data, like that. So now we need to implement the constructor. So this needs data and this needs a key. And this needs a widget. Then we have to do super key key and child child, because we need to pass only those two elements to the super class. Okay, so now here, as data, we will pass this, which is this entire instance, this entire class. And as a child, we will pass widget child. So this is the reference. So each state class, as I said in one of the first episodes, each state class has a getter called widget, which is a reference to the other class of this widget, to the stateful widget, so to this widget over here. So we have to just add this widget here like that. As you can see, the error disappeared. And this has to be final within this class. So now we need to just create a constructor, like so. The final piece is to provide the off method. So this time we will do it here in this stateful widget, because this is the widget that's being exposed externally. This is the class that will be used by other classes in our application, by other widgets. And all those classes here, the inherited widget is private. And that's the reason the off method must be placed over here. So let's implement that. So again, this is static. And for convenience, this will be returning ugly provider state of build context context return context as before. But this time you have to reference the actual inherited widget. So this widget over here. Like that, and we need to cast it again. And we need to reference the data. Like so. Okay, so the widget is done. It's time to use it. So I will, for that reason, I will go to the calendar screen, this screen over here, which is empty, and I will implement a counter just to show you how it all works. So the first thing is to use this a new provider, this new inherited widget. So let me go to main, and we've already wrapped the whole application with this previous provider. So I don't want to change that because we'll be using that in the future. So I will wrap just this app. So it's almost the same. It's just one or two levels lower, but it's still the entire application is being wrapped with this new inherited widget. And then we will remove that. So this is ugly provider. And now in this example, I don't have to provide the data as I did here, because the data comes from the state class. It's inside this whole provider. So it's slightly different than in this case. Here it's just more transparent, more declarative. We are saying what we want to provide and to whom. And here this data is inside this class as the state. So all the fields you want to share, you have to define them in a sort of state class. Okay, so I wrapped this, so now I can access this from any widget down below the app widget. I can reference ugly provider, and then I can reference the data. So I will use that from within the calendar screen. So here, if I already reference that, if I say state and I say ugly provider of context, like that, I should be able to display the initial value. Let's see if it works. So it's going to be state. Let's do it slightly differently, like that. Okay, and now you have the number one, so it works. Okay, so let's improve that even more, because we created this provider to be able to replace the inherited widget each time something changes. So we need to an action which will change the state. So let's implement increment. And this needs to execute the set state. And here we will be incrementing the counter. Okay, so now let's go ahead and add floating action button. And let's say floating action button on pressed. And this on pressed will be state increment, so the method we just defined. Okay, so I have the button, I have the counter, and then when I click, the counter increments. So it's good, but that's not all that's interesting here. So now we have two widgets that uses the data from the state in one place. We are using it within one build method, but we don't have to because that's the reason we introduced the inherited widget. So let's decouple this. Let's put it aside and see how we can use that. So first of all, I will create just a simple class called counter, and this will be stateless class counter, like that. And I will just take this part here, the body, and I will display it here, like that. Okay, so I have the counter. I just need to quickly copy those two lines so I can access the inherited widget directly from this counter, and like that. And now I can replace the body with a counter, and I don't have to pass anything to this class because this class knows how to access the data through the inherited widget we provided. So now it works as before. We can do the same for the floating action button. So let's create another class and let's call it fab button. And again, this is a stateless widget, like that. And let's copy this part over here, this whole floating action button inside this new widget. So this widget will be returning the floating action button. And again, we just need to reference the inherited widget, which wraps this whole tree of widgets. And here, and the floating action button, I don't need to pass anything. I can just say fab button. I need to import the class. And now I can remove that because I no longer use the counter. I no longer use the state. I don't have to reference my inherited widget here in this calendar screen because it's referenced from counter and from fab button. So now it still works. So as you can see, my I construct the widgets and they are empty. I don't have to pass anything because the widgets know how to access the data from the place they want to. So that's the first point, but we can go even further because, as I said, whenever you use this off, you subscribe this widget to changes. So Flutter knows that it should rebuild this this widget. So let's test it out. So I will go back to Ugly Provider and I will slightly improve this off method, and I will pass a parameter called subscribe, and this will be true by default. And now here I can say if it's true, use the previous method. But if it's false, there is another method called ancestor inherited element from widget of exact type. And it's exactly the same. So I have to reference the inherited widget. I need to cast it. Use the widget because I'm accessing an element. I will explain the difference between widget and element in one of the future episodes. But for now, let's just roll with that. And data, like that. Okay, just to wrap up. So if the subscribe is true and this is default, we will use this method, which subscribes this widget to changes. And if it's false and it's set explicitly, we'll use another method. And if you read the documentation of this method, it says that this method does not establish a relation with the target in any way that inherit from widget of exact type does. So it does not subscribe the widget to the changes. So now I have this optional parameter here in the off, and if I change and I say subscribe false and I restart, I go here and I start clicking, the counter is not incremented. I mean, it's not displayed, but it is incremented behind the scenes. So if I change to true, it will display right away number of clicks I just did. So as you can see, by default, if you are using the off method, and namely if you are using this inherit from widget of exact type, Flutter behind the scenes subscribes this widget to changes, so that whenever something happens with the state, this widget is being rebuilt. So now the last point, probably one of the most important ones. So there were some questions about the fact that if I wrapped here in the main the app with ugly provider, and now we are changing this inherited widget each time there is a set state, does it rebuild the whole application? So we can just simply test this, and within the app, so on the highest possible level, just before the point we wrapped by inherited by ugly provider, we can just do print, and we can say app, and we can see the debug console. So now we have app. So remember that whenever I click the button, the ugly provider will be rebuilt, which means that there will be new inherited widget. And this widget is one step above the app. So theoretically, it should rebuild everything below, but it won't. So if I click, as you can see, the app is not being rebuilt. And the reason is that when you create this ugly provider, we are passing the child as final. So once you set the instance, which is this class over here, app, the instance of app is passed as a child to ugly provider, so to this class, it's being assigned here to this final, so it will never change, and that's the reason Flutter will not rebuild the whole tree. So from now on, it will only rebuild the widgets that use this method to access the state. So that's the default behavior. But if you want to explicitly say that you don't want to subscribe this widget to changes, you need to use another method. And this is basically something which Scoped Model does behind the scenes. That's the whole idea. So first of all, I think you shouldn't use this approach. And secondly, it's simple enough that if you need it, you now understand how it works and you can just develop it by hand. You don't need to rely on other widgets. I think that concludes the episode. We will remove that part now, and in the next episode, I will finally present you the architecture I'm hoping to use in this whole application. The architecture we will explore, and hopefully you will find it easy and simple to use. See you next time.